Hey guys, welcome back to the It's me, PB, your host. Are you looking to download fonts to your computer or your Macintosh? Is the process really slow and cumbersome? Here's an easy way to do it. Open google.com, go to github.com. I'm giving you the link in the description box below. Just open up Mac WinRepo and there you will be able to see Google Fonts. And just follow the instructions here. All you have to do is just copy this line of code and just run it from your terminal. This will install all of the Google Fonts which is available in the library. Just make sure that like you have a good computer or a Macintosh so that it doesn't slow up your computer or take up a lot of system resources. So any computer which is like late 2015 should be like able to run this or take up all the font load of the Google library. So now you can see that in the fonts, open font book from here. I have over 61 fonts which comes default with the Mac OS. Now I'm just going to open my terminal and I just copy this code and run this code from the terminal. You could see that it starts the downloading of the font. It downloads over 1,000+ fonts, so the download size is almost like 300 MB in size. So you could see that the download has started now. Once the download is complete, it will start installing all the fonts. This makes your job easier and you need not install font by font. You can just install all the font at once. This download is dependent on your internet speeds as well. So just make sure you have a good internet speed so that the download gets completed in less than a minute. It's taking almost like 40 seconds to me now. So you can install over 1,000 fonts in less than a minute. Once the download is complete, it will start the installation. It would ask you for your admin password. Just log in your admin password. Okay, the download is complete. It's extracting the fonts now. It asks for admin password. I just key in the admin password of my computer. So once I give in the password, it will start the installation and install all the fonts. Okay, the installation is complete now. It's less than like 57 seconds to do the installation. Now if I go to my font book and if I happen to see there, I'll be able to see all the fonts getting installed here. Let me close up font book. Okay, it's loading automatically. If it doesn't load automatically, you can close the font book and open it again. So it's now has almost 1,122 fonts. It's installing more, in fact. This is applicable to both Mac OS as well as Linux because this is your shell command. So you can to just run this code. If you want to uninstall these fonts, say for example in the future you feel that you don't want any of these fonts and it is taking a lot of system resources, it's making your Word document slow or your Photoshop files really slow to see the font preview, all you have to do is just open up this font book, go to the file menu, take the option as restore standard fonts. I've given it here as well in the comments. So click on launchpad and take the font book, go to the file menu and restore the standard fonts. This will reset all these fonts and bring back my old library which comes default with the OS. And if you are a Windows user, all you have to do is just download this zip file. This GitHub is from Google, a more reliable and authentic source. Just download this link. It'll start the fonts download. Just give your location. And you can just start the installation, download the files. So once the download is complete, you'll be able to extract and see the fonts. In Windows, you have to install them font by font actually. So download is almost ready now. It's almost 300 plus MB in size. So once it is extracted, you can just go to the fonts folder and just install them manually. Like double click on the fonts, it will automatically start the installation in Windows. Okay, it's completed. It's 392 MB in size. Just go to this folder, extract this fonts. So this will have all your fonts into this. If you happen to see here, go to the official font release, you'll be able to see list of all the fonts available inside this. This is your entire Google library. Just go into any of these fonts and just double click on this two type font, TTF. So you have the complete list here. You'll be able to take them from here. Or if you wanted to avoid this process and just install the fonts which you prefer, then you can go to fonts.com. They also have something called the Sky Fonts, which gives you the complete Google library. We call them as the web fonts, the web safe fonts. Go to web fonts. There you have the option as Sky Fonts. Just key in as Google there in the address bar, and you'll be able to see something called the Sky Fonts. This is a small application which is free. Start the installation, and once the installation is completed, you'll be able to choose the fonts which you prefer, and it gets automatically updated whenever there's an update from the font provider. So you'll be able to see a list of all the fonts available. You can just click on the box and the installation starts, and this will get automatically synced every time you open your computer or even you run your fonts updates. To check all the fonts, the list of fonts and the previews available, you can go to google.com with the prefix fonts. There you'll be able to see a list of fonts available, and you can just download any of the fonts. Say for example I need Open Sans, go to Open Sans. Then you can choose the style you need, light, bold, semi-bold, and select the style, and then you can just download the family. It'll give you the entire family of that. If you want special characters in your font, when you type a document or when you're trying to draw something or you're making a design in Photoshop, if you want any of the special fonts or something, then we have another library for that. We call that as Font Awesome, where you can go and take picture fonts. Go to the Font Awesome library. So there you'll be able to see a list of all the icons or all the fonts which are available there. You just have to download this font. This is a free font. Just download this and you'll be able to use all these fonts when you're typing in. So all these fonts are available there as well. So when you click on free, you'll be able to see almost 1588 icons are available. If you are a web developer or a UI developer, you would be able to take advantage of all these icons, as all these are like vectors and they are all SVG formats. I think that's pretty much it. If you have any comments, just leave in the comment box below. And do share this video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.